Hey there, I am joined right now by what we, I guess you go by Global Explorer, right? Mike Libecki. He's coming to Des Moines here on the 30th of January, kind of just talking about your experiences, Mike. So I guess, first of all, just kind of tell us about yourself. Is Global Explorer an accurate description for you?
Yeah, well, thanks for having me. It's great to be here and talk about the presentation that's coming up. But yeah, I'm Mike Libecki. The fancy title is National Geographic Explorer, and I'm a professional climber, conservationist. I support a lot of science. I do a lot of humanitarian work around the world. But yeah, the passion is traveling the world, climbing, giving back to our planet, trying to make it a better place, working on global issues that have to do with our natural world. So yeah, you know, just the question is why rash and passion, and I'm pursuing that passion of enthusiasm I have for exploring this planet.
So give us a little preview for those that may be thinking about coming to the Civic Center in Des Moines. What are they gonna, or what can they expect you're gonna share with us?
We're gonna go to places that no humans have been to before. So this is true modern day exploration. So polar bears, we're gonna talk about issues with our climate, issues with our planet, but really it's sharing the magic and power and beauty of our Mother Earth. And it's gonna be emotional in many different ways. So I highly recommend you come out and spend some time with this great community, listen to these stories, and I think you're gonna walk away saying, how can I make the world a better place? Let's take care of our Mother Earth here.
Yeah, that's a great message. And I guess I always kind of like to ask people that have had the experiences that you have, is there, can you pinpoint a highlight or a favorite thing or place that you've been to or done?
You know, that's a great question. And it's a tough one because, you know, pushing 100 expeditions, well over 100 countries, I've been very fortunate and privileged to have so many experiences around the world. But I mean, Greenland is one of my favorite places. The Northern Arctic and Antarctica, they're really hard to beat, but all of them are so hard to compare. But being around polar bears and bringing back the stories of polar bears is really, really a powerful thing for me. And you know, the best part about this lifestyle is getting to experience all these places. The second best part is bringing these stories home to share with people. And I feel responsible to bring these stories home so people can not only experience this planet that, you know, a lot of places that people don't go to, but to feel the emotions that, you know, are on our planet and in nature.
Yeah, and you talk about, you know, you're truly on the front lines, so to speak, of these parts of the world that are maybe more sensitive to changes in extreme weather or our climate. So, I mean, what are some of those maybe alarm bells or triggers of alarm bells of things that you have seen yourself being out in some of these remote places or places that are most affected by these things?
Yeah, that's another great question. And, you know, we all hear about climate change. And my own experience with 30 years of exploring the world, climate change is very real. And we don't have to get into why that is happening, but it is real, and there are issues affecting, for example, polar bears, which I'll be talking a lot about polar bears. And I hope you come to the talk because there are things I'm going to share that are truly emotional. But polar bears are an endangered species. I've seen this firsthand. I've seen glaciers that are 3,000 feet long that are melted and no longer there anymore, and this is my own experience. So we're gonna talk about issues of the planet, but we're also gonna talk about happy, joyful, exciting things of just beauty of our planet, and it's gonna be a really fun time.
You talk about your personal goal of 100 by 100. So I guess, what does that mean for you?
Yeah, so the 100 by 100 comes back to just my math and physics background, and I look at everything really mathematical and like equations, and within that is setting goals. So I thought, oh gosh, what a great goal to set of 100 expeditions by 100 years old, and I'm officially about 10 expeditions away from that. So I think I'm going to surpass that goal, but I haven't reached it yet, but I'm on, you know, I have this organic enthusiasm to reach that goal. But I love setting goals. I think that in life, you know, there's a few things. It's like someone to love, something to do, something to look forward to. And I love looking forward to these expeditions, not only planning them, but can I succeed on them? So, goal setting, it's a big deal. I love it.
Well, I mean, if you've already hit 90, I think you're pretty close to hitting that 100 mark already. So pretty, looks like a goal that you're going to be set to reach. Is there anything that you wish people knew that you've seen or experienced, or if they're thinking about coming out to your talk?
You know, there's a lot of stuff that I want to share. What I've learned, things that are parallel commonalities to everyday life. I mean, from surviving in minus 70 degrees to climbing literally the biggest rock walls on the planet, there are things I want to share, but I think I'm going to ask you to come on out to the presentation so I can share those with you in person. We can have these conversations, but I highly recommend you come out because the teams that I work with, these aren't stories just from myself. These are stories from all of the teamwork, my film crew, my photographer crew, all the people I do this with. I mean, it's hundreds, if not thousands of people that make these possible. And we want to share these stories with you, and we want to inspire you to just be grateful that we have this incredible reality on this beautiful planet. So come on out. I'd love to share those stories with you.
Okay, awesome. And I guess something I meant to ask you a little bit earlier, how long have you been doing this? And I guess how has both your just wonder at the sights and just the scenery itself changed through that time?
You know, I've been doing this for just about 30 years. So when I started college, I started climbing, and the climbing world took me into this whole adventure lifestyle. And how that happened was my grandmother sat me down when I was 18 years old. She said, "What do you really want to do in your life?" And I said, "I want to climb and explore." So I took the learning of math that I talked about to adventure and exploration and really focused on it. But the things that I've seen and experienced, again, I feel really privileged and honored. And that's where my responsibility comes in, to share these stories with other people. But we're going to be around polar bears. We're going to see issues with our Earth. We're going to meet interesting culture. And I hope that I can bring emotions from this world and these experiences so people can feel them themselves.
Okay, awesome. Thank you so much. Mike Libecki, National Geographic Adventurer, thanks for joining us for this little bit. And we look forward to you getting to visit Des Moines and for your talk at the Civic Center coming up.
Yeah, please come on out. There's going to be some interesting surprises that I'm going to reveal in this show. So I hope to see you there. And I really appreciate your time and help spreading the word.
All right, that's a great tease. You have us all on the edge of our seat. Thanks so much.